Hi everyone, this is your instructor, Francis Carls. In this short video, we're going to go over how to determine what the gametes are going to look like in a dihybrid cross. You have some problems over dihybrid crosses in your homework for this week, and students always seem to struggle with determining what the gametes are going to look like. So here's a sample problem, and it gives you the genotypes of the parents down here and asked you to make that cross in a dihybrid Punnett square. So we're going to go over how to do that right now. So the first step is to form your gametes. You pick a parent to start with, and then afterwards you'll go back and do the second parent using the same process. In this example, our parents actually look alike, so when you do one, you're actually making the gametes for both. There are four different letters here, so you're going to end up with four different gametes, and they're each going to have half as many letters as your parents, because that's what happens in meiosis, is we divide the chromosome number in half. So our FOIL method, you take the first R and put it with the first Y. That gives you capital R, capital Y. Outer is your O in FOIL. That's your first R with your second Y. That gives you your second gamete. Inner is your second R with your first Y, third gamete. And last is your second R with your second Y, and that gives you your fourth gamete. Now you have all four gametes, and you can put them in your Punnett square. Like I said, both parents actually look exactly alike, so your gametes for both parents are going to look exactly alike. You put one set across the top and one set along the side. And then, to complete your problem, you are just filling in boxes. And you do that the same way you did for a monohybrid cross. Let me know if you have any questions. Thanks.